What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Star Wars The Old Republic. We're over here, about to do the mission taking on Toborro. Access the secret entrance of Dr. Ogro, which is right here. Went right ahead. Already went ahead and traveled all the way over here, just to expedite the situation. Head on down to maintenance level. Probably Jinx. Get weird if it was Jinx.
Your hidden entrance appears to be unguarded, Doctor.
Of course. Toborro doesn't even know it exists. He has no eye for such exquisite detail. He is also despairingly predictable, and almost certainly ranting away in his throne room while clutching the fuel rods to his bosom. I am transmitting procedures to defeat the security protocols separating you from Toborro. Follow them precisely. I'll be unable to reach you via holo after this.
Get your aid.
We can take things from here. You've been most helpful. The Republic will remember your cooperation.
Perhaps your Supreme Chancellor will reward me with my own private laboratory. The planet Tisharon would be perfect. A last word of advice. Toborro asked for some rather unorthodox droid designs. It's possible he actually built a few. If so, good luck with them.
Nice palace. Very hut-like, with all of the carbon statues around here.
Kikumiya Konona.
release the imprisoned security chief. Obtain security chief's assets card. Gotta kill him? I do. Grateful that I had his freedom. Guess not, though. I suppose not. Keep skipping as long as we can. No need to kill all these guys. We don't have to. And backwards. People are what matter.
This planet may not be around much longer, but its people will always be part of the Republic.
And you will face justice.
You destroyed this world, enslaved and murdered people, and for what? Vanity. You're done, Toborro. Surrender.
Toborro's glittering power. Oh, I will. Can't conserve any but anything this guy does, so that's fun. Suppose I wasn't far enough out of that. Could have moved farther away. Actually think that would be our first death on this character that we haven't fell down. I think we died by falling off of a roof once or twice. And you know what? Go tank for me. Go die for me, Finn. Well, that was fun. I actually do like these fights with these guys, especially the raid. The raid was fun. Sorry, I can't save you.
You left us no chance to get you out of here alive, Toborro. Goodbye.
I could have sworn this didn't end until the raid actually finished. I could be wrong. Well, I was obviously wrong. I could have swore that was where the last cinematic was. Not like it really matters. Most of the ending cinematics are slightly anticlimactic.
I demand I have a spot on the Ark.
At least for the first couple of expansions.
More like resting on your laurels for generations.
The Ark's fuel rods, as promised. Toborro's gone, along with his entire supply of isotope 5.
The whole planet felt it. Lambda says the explosion triggered a chain reaction in the planet's core. If you have unfinished business, better make it quick. I'll take the fuel rods and get our people to work installing them. I left a shielded shuttle here at the camp. It's your ticket off Makeb. The rest of us are taking the Ark.
Any more help?
You sure there's nothing else that needs to be done? Have all the planet's refugees made it aboard the Ark?
The ship is full and ready to fly. Thanks to you, we're about to achieve the fastest planetary evacuation in galactic history. I hope we meet again on Keylander Station.
Or command post shuttle. It's this way. Apparently.
Fuel rods are in place. Power levels are at 80%. I hope it's enough.
It'll have to be. Lambda says there's a fissure opening directly beneath us. We're launching before the mesa collapses.
You're safe. When our scouts reported the catastrophe on the surface, we feared the worst.
Everyone safe?
Did all our people make it off the cab in time?
Reports are still coming in, but so far, so good. Please meet me in Keylander Station's conference chamber. We have much to discuss.
Will do.
The Supreme Chancellor requested a meeting.
Welcome back. I was informed that you survived a terrifying ordeal. You have my deepest admiration. Ah, here they are.
Millions of hungry mouths to feed and nothing to show for it. You pledged Makeb to us, Shalem, and you knew it was doomed.
We had no idea the planet was that unstable. Our offer was made in good faith.
My uncle is a businessman, Chancellor. But in this case, he's telling the truth.
You knew the groundquakes were getting worse. You used the Republic, knowing we'd be obligated to help your people even if you had nothing to offer in return.
It wasn't that simple.
They didn't know Makeb was doomed, only that the groundquakes were increasing after the huts took over. They didn't voice all of their suspicions, but they were trying to save lives. Would we have acted any different?
That hardly matters now. This is a debacle. We came here seeking resources to defeat the Sith Empire. Instead, we're walking away with debts and obligations.
What about the Hutt leaders? You negotiated a peace agreement with them, didn't you?
Yes, we've made them allies.
He's right. The cartel leaders have promised to support the Republic wholeheartedly.
So we have a worthless ally and a broken one. Still, the Hutts possess considerable wealth. Only the cartel leaders who needed rescuing agree to this alliance. Fortunately, they possess most of the wealth and power. They'll neutralize any holdouts. With our new friend's wealth and warships, we've gained a substantial advantage over the Empire. That doesn't address the problem of Makeb's people, however. I need a solution.
The Hutts can provide aid.
The Republic needs to establish a haven for war victims. I can't think of anyone more deserving than the people of Makeb. The Hutts have plenty of credits to fund the construction of new homes, and we can use their fleet to protect them.
I had to twist your arm to call the Republic. Glad you finally swallowed that spirit of independence?
After everything we've been through, to receive such generosity. Thank you all.
You'll be a good leader?
The people of Makeb need someone guiding them to their new home. I think you're the right person for that job, Shalem.
I'm not. But you've shown me what a true leader looks like. I'll follow that example.
I want to speak with my operative in private. Please excuse us. You've made the best of an unfortunate situation. Well done. The Hutts want to be on the winning side of this war, and you've shown them who that is. We have you alone to thank for this alliance.
Yeah, war isn't over yet.
And we still have plenty of fighting to do. The Empire isn't falling anytime soon.
Indeed. Which brings me to my next point. For too long, the Republic has wasted time reacting to the enemy. We must fight this war to win by going on the offensive. Savor this victory. Return to the war's front lines and press our advantage. Together, we will be triumphant.
Shadow of Revan. Prelude. Speak to T3G2. On the fleet. Has got any vendors around here? Yeah, you got one.
Best prices this side of the galaxy. You check.
Jacket action. Yeah, I don't like that. Don't like backpacks in this game. or whatever those things are.
Appreciate your business.
Can't do that here, can't do that here. Let's go to the ship. And we'll probably end it here. Continue on to the Shadow of Revan next time. So, thank you for watching, and as always, have a great day. We'll see you next time.